I'm going to try and avoid tonight jokes about women. I don't want to be sexist. But as you've seen in the news lately, a bit of a grey area. Well, the key's in grey area, that is. I'll leave it to the experts, eh? Who would hate to judge Sean Massey? Female linesman. Well, lines person, should I say, to be correct. Takes balls to do that job, doesn't it? Yeah, who should, you know. Who would hate to judge her? You'll see more lines than Charlie Sheen. I mean, if ever there was a guy with a more appropriate name, Charlie Sheen, eh? Charlie. Class A drug, Sheen. Number one household product for cleaning your dust. I mean, not the best joke, obviously. My jokes are, they are like trains. Hope this works. Oh, excuse me.
Hello.
Okay. I'm afraid to tell you all, there is a delay in your next joke. Well, how are we all doing anyway? Are we all right?
Yeah.
Nice to see you all. Thank you very much. How are you, Sean? You all right?
I'm bloody brilliant.
How about you, sir? Are you okay?
Yeah, you lost.
Lost a lot of steps up here, mate. Bit of an awkward conversation. Brilliant. I spend all day trying to avoid these awkward conversations. I mean, awkward. Pain in the ass. Just walking downtown the other day. I was to trap my wire in my stick. I didn't really. Walking through town the other day and I spot someone. Well, do. I spot someone, I know they're going to speak to me, I don't really want to speak to them, as you do. Nobody important. Just your brother. You see, you want to avoid them, really. So what we're doing, you try the first technique, you cross the road, don't you? Obviously backwards and forwards to get across the road, isn't it? Now, if that technique doesn't work, what you do secondly, you try the shadow technique. You try walking down other pedestrians. And hopefully that works, and if it doesn't, you have to make a mad dash. And I was on to the supermarket then, where we spotted someone else we don't want to speak to. Because of the alphabetical system at school, I had to sit next to this person for 5 years. They think they're my friend, but I'm not. So we're trying to avoid these people turning towards them. And obviously you've got to turn towards the clothes section first, because that's the rules. So you head to the clothes section, they spot you across the aisles. What you've got to do, you've got to hide. First thing you try, you freeze. Obviously, never pass for a mannequin. No one had ever used this dress since. Second technique, you hide, you try, you hide amongst the clothes. Then you're a coat hanger. But you can feel them getting closer and closer. And you start to panic, you make a mad dash for the till, you want to escape. At the till, you then realise you've actually not got any of the shopping you wanted. You have a look around, you have a Mars bar. Mars bar will do it. Onto the till. It's good, I've had a good day, I've avoided two awkward conversations so far. Fantastic. Next thing you hear is, how are you? How's your mother? It's like, no! Leave me alone! Just serve me! At this point, I looked up and the customer and said, do you mind? It's not your turn yet. At this point, I felt really embarrassed. Turned all red, like a ginger, just got off a sunbed. I'm making a mad dash home. How far is the club shade like? Go home, relax. I get home, the phone rings. Phone. Not like the real thing. This guy on the phone said, hello, who's that?
Hello there, sir. Hello, Mr. Potter, how are you doing?
I said, it's Potter, it's a novelist.
Well, we understand your tariff keeps running over each week, each month. Would you like to be interested in getting a higher tariff to keep your bill low.
I said, it's not really my bill you want to worry about, keep ringing me from India, is it?
Next point, I'm trying to carry on, trying to have a relaxing day still, and obviously, next point is the fire alarm, the smoke alarm sounds, indicating our house tea's ready, or over ready, that is. I mean, how's it going for tea? Next thing I hear, somebody at the bloody door, isn't there? I go to the door, I answer the door, there's a guy from British Gas there. I said, oh, I know what you bloody want, knocking on the door in winter. I open my door, let the heat out in the bloody street. He says, no, sir, it's nothing like that. I want to know if you want to change gas provider. I said, let me check with the wife. Let me put you on hold. Shut the door. Hello, someone from Chris's Gas. Well, he's ready. Tell him to go away. Fair enough. Open the door. Sorry, sir, could you call back in another time? He says, yeah, well, when's best for you? I said, how about Sunday? Can you come back Sunday? He says, well, that's inconvenient for me. I said, well, that'll do me. That'll be great, eh? I'll get you out soon. So I get to the table. The old lad sat there, he's eating his tea. So I sat there, take a break on the left, tea in the middle, laptop on the right, tapping away. So what's happening here, Luke? And she says, like, come on, let's go. And that's why nobody knows how to communicate with you. That's why I don't know. I've been hooked on this. I'm tapping away all day, every day, chatting to people. Face to face, we don't know what's going on. But, you know, Facebook, she's tapping and poking, I'm not working if you're around poking people. I mean, it's not right, is it? I tried this once. I was hanging around the takeaway shops. What was it? It's a bit of a hobby of mine, actually, hanging around takeaway shops, as you can tell. I went up to the floor, so I said, there you are, poke. A bit of a poke, right? And I said, we've got 10 friends in common. Fancy being my friend? And she says, yeah, sure. And then, you know, a year later, I ended up married, so that bloody showed me, didn't it? Showed me for being a smart ass. So it wasn't married, though. Maybe on the way. Yay! I'll cheer if you don't. My hard work, thank you. I'm looking forward to it, really. Obviously, I have to ward this one off eBay. It's a lack of communication skills we've got. Looking forward to the day of arrival when you come home, find a note in the door saying we've missed you today, call next door. Brilliant. But yeah, babies, they're brilliant, aren't they? You know, all bold, toothless, a bit smelly, juggalo. But everyone finds them so cute and brilliant. When I get to 60 and I'm bold and I've got no teeth left and I'm a little bit smelly, how am I going to be found cute then? And you're like, I don't think so, is it? I really not going to be. But you know, children, they're brilliant. Amazes me about children, how flexible they are. You know, I wish I'd have kept a bit of that flexibility from youth, like. I mean, I wouldn't be alive then, would I? No, definitely not. But I'd never get there anyway, bloody belly's in the way. But I have been training hard over the winter months. I'm doing a bit of running. A weight training. Brilliant. Punch the bag a few times. I have to get her out of bed. It's a good old ass one. But no, the wife's brilliant, though. She's there all the time. You know, when you're in bed, what do you need to do there? Are you showing her under cover afterwards? Yep, that's right. When I come home from work, yep. Are you checking your wallet? Yep, she's been in there too. Well, she's wonderful, really. I mean, I like to call her the joke griefer. She doesn't find me funny in the slightest. As only a few of you are. But that's brilliant. She doesn't find me funny in the slightest, anyway. Not with my clothes on. She's never given on that short performance. Unfortunately, it has been a short performance. And I'd like to say thank you all for listening.
And back to Stefan.
Thank you very much,
Stefan.
And coffee,
it was very nice, though.
Did you have interest in why you're going to clean up?